Hello, Glendale Community College students. Welcome to Chapter 11. Chapter 11 is on the topic of stoichiometry, which basically means we're going to do calculations with chemical equations. So let's get started. Section 1, mole ratios. So there's a balanced equation right there. 2 NO gas plus oxygen gas makes 2 NO2 gas. Now, there's a couple of ways we can interpret this chemical reaction. One is to say two molecules of NO react with one molecule of oxygen to make two molecules of the product NO2. But again, in the real world, we can't pick out little molecules. They're too small, so we can't add two molecules to a molecule and rub them together and get products. So we add moles together, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd molecules in one mole, if you remember from the last chapter. So another way to interpret this balanced equation is two moles of NO react with one mole of oxygen gas to make two moles of the product, NO2. So we're going to use those mole ratios to do some math in this chapter. And that's really the only thing new for the first part of this chapter. Let's look at our second balanced reaction right here. Nitrogen gas plus 3 hydrogen gas makes 2 NH3 gas. NH3 is ammonia. Again, we can think of that as one molecule of nitrogen plus 3 molecules of hydrogen make 2 molecules of ammonia. But it's more helpful for us to do it in moles. One mole of nitrogen gas makes 3 moles of hydrogen gas plus 3 moles of hydrogen gas makes 2 moles of ammonia. So these coefficients, the 1, the 3, and the 2, give us molecule or mole ratios. And it's mole ratios that are going to be useful for us. So let's see how that works in some math. All right, mole ratios. Here's another balanced reaction. 1 Fe2O3 solid plus 3 carbon monoxide gas will produce 2 iron solid plus 3 carbon dioxide gas. So we can do mole ratios. Examples, 1 mole of Fe2O3 over 3 moles of CO. All we do is put ratios together in a fraction form. 3 moles of CO over 1 mole of Fe2O3, or 2 moles of Fe over 3 moles of CO, etc., etc. We're going to make ratios out of these chemicals using that coefficient. So we can answer questions like number 1. How many moles of iron can be formed if we have 10.2 moles of carbon monoxide? Notice this question involves two chemicals and we have a balanced reaction. That's how you know it's stoichiometry. You have two chemicals in the question, not one, but two, and you have to have a balanced reaction to go with it. So in number 1, we have iron, which is Fe solid. And we have carbon monoxide. What's carbon monoxide? CO, right? 1O, CO, not CO2, CO. So again, those are the two chemicals we're going to focus on. The other two chemicals are not in this problem, so don't worry about them. Let's start with what we're given. We know there's 10.2 moles of carbon monoxide, so write that down. 10.2 moles CO. Now we're asking about moles of iron. So to switch chemicals, we use a mole ratio. The moles that we start with needs to be on the bottom to cancel out. The moles we're trying to find needs to be on top because that's what we end with. So what chemical needs to be on the bottom? You're correct if you said CO. And how many COs are in the balanced reaction? 3 of them. So 3 moles of CO is on the bottom of our conversion factor. What is on top? What are we trying to find? iron. And how many moles of iron are in the balanced reaction? 2. So 2 moles of Fe is on top, and it looks like this. 10.2 moles of CO times 2 moles of Fe over 3 moles of CO. Moles of CO cancel out. And when we punch that into our calculator, we get 6.80 moles of Fe. Why do we have to add a zero to the end of 6.8? Because we needed 3 sig figs, right? Mole ratios are exact. It's exactly 2 moles of Fe to 3 moles of CO. That's exact. So what we started with was 3 sig figs, so we need to end with 3 sig figs. So we need 6.80 moles of Fe. All right, number 2. How many moles of iron 3 oxide are needed to form 17 moles of carbon dioxide? Again, we have 2 chemicals. Iron 3 oxide, which chemical is that in the reaction? Iron 3 oxide. Must be something with iron and oxygen. So Fe2O3, yeah, Fe2O3 is iron 3 oxide. Carbon dioxide, what's that? Yes, if you said CO2, carbon dioxide is CO2. So those are the 2 chemicals in this question. Don't worry about the other chemicals. They're not involved. Start with what you're given. 17 moles of CO2. Now, which moles needs to be on the bottom this time for our conversion factor? Moles of CO2. How many CO2s are in the reaction? 3, right? So 3 moles of CO2s on the bottom. What are we finding? Moles of Fe2O3. So that's on top. How many moles of Fe2O3 are in the reaction? 1. 1 mole of Fe2O3. So that's our conversion factor. Let's see what that looks like. There we go. 17 moles of CO2. 1 mole of Fe2O3 on top over 3 moles of CO2. Moles of CO2 cancel out. And we're left with 5.7 moles Fe2O3. Why is the answer 5.7 and not something 5.7 whatever? Yeah, because we started with 2 sig figs in this problem. 17 has 2 sig figs. So we round it to 5.7 moles Fe2O3. All right, let's look at another example. I want you to do this. I want you to balance this reaction, answer the 2 questions. I want you to pause and do this. What's really funny to me is on my exams, I'll have students miss mole ratio calculations. I think it's just one step and they try to make it more difficult than it really is. So make sure you understand these before we move on. Try to do these on your own. All right, we're back. Hopefully you balanced the reaction. We needed 2 SO2s plus just 1 oxygen gas to make the product 2 SO3. So we have our balanced reaction. Question number 1, how many moles of SO3 will form if 0.165 moles of oxygen gas react? Again, we have 2 chemicals, SO3 and oxygen. 2 chemicals and a balanced reaction means it's a stoichiometry problem. We're going to have a mole ratio in there. Write down what you're given, 0.165 moles of oxygen gas. So our conversion factor is going to be moles over moles. Moles of what's on the bottom? Moles of oxygen. How many oxygens are in that balanced equation? 1. Good job. What moles is on top? Well, the moles that we're finding, SO3. And how many SO3s are in the balanced equation? 2. So our mole ratio is 2:1. And it looks like that. 0.165 moles of oxygen times 2 moles of SO3 over 1 mole of O2. Moles of O2 cancel, and it equals 0.330 moles of SO3. Hopefully you got that one. Last problem, and we'll take a break. How many moles of SO2 are needed to make 0.042 moles of sulfur trioxide? Again, we have two chemicals, SO2 and sulfur trioxide. What chemical is sulfur trioxide? Hopefully you said SO3. So those are the two chemicals. We have a balanced reaction. It's a stoichiometry problem. We're going to have a mole ratio in this problem. Start with what you're given. 0.042 moles of sulfur trioxide, SO3. Then we have our conversion factor, our mole ratio. Which moles is on the bottom? 2 moles of SO3 is on the bottom. What's on top? 2 moles of SO2 are on top. And it looks like this. It's a 2-to-2 mole ratio. So 2 divided by 2 is 1. So the answer is 0.042 moles of SO2. We still have to show the work because moles of SO3 canceled out from our given to the bottom, and we're left with moles of SO2. We changed chemicals when we do a mole ratio. All right, more to come. Stay with me. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.